Good morning, children. In the last class, we have gone through integers chapter, isn't it? And we have discussed some of the important definitions like natural numbers, whole numbers, positive numbers, negative numbers, and integers, isn't it? What do you mean by these natural numbers? All the counting numbers are called natural numbers, and always the natural numbers start from 1. They are represented by an alphabet N. Natural numbers are represented by an alphabet N. See, which are the natural numbers here? 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. These are the set of all natural numbers. Next, whole numbers. All the natural numbers including 0 are called whole numbers. In these whole numbers, all the natural numbers will be present, and also along with 0 are known as whole numbers. These whole numbers are represented by an alphabet W. See, these are the set of all whole numbers. Next, we have discussed about positive numbers. What do you mean by positive numbers? Positive numbers are the numbers which are greater than 0. Numbers which are greater than 0 are known as positive numbers. Positive numbers means which are the numbers greater than 0. Greater than 0 means after 0 we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to infinity. Next is negative numbers. Negative numbers are the numbers less than 0. The numbers which are less than 0 are known as negative numbers. And always the numbers have minus sign in front of them. The numbers which are less than 0 are minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 up to infinity. And next we have discussed about integers. What do you mean by integers? It is a collection of both positive numbers and negative numbers, and also along with 0, or known as integers. Integers are represented by an alphabet Z or I, where Z is a German word. It is Zahlen. See, here is a set of all integers. In the right side of the 0, we will be having negative integers. Sorry, in the left side of the 0, we will be having negative integers. And right side of the 0, we will be having positive integers. And also we have seen how to represent the integers on a number line. See, this is a number line. Each are off at a equal distance, that is 1 centimeter each. See, right side of the 0 we are having positive integers, and left side of the 0 we are having negative integers. And also we have gone through some of the examples. We have marked minus 4 on the number line and also plus 5 on the number line. See, here they have given some of the example. Here they asked us to compare the following pair of numbers. Here they have given pair of numbers. They asked us to fill the boxes with the greater number sign or the lesser than sign. See, we know that in the last class we know that as we moving on the right side of the zero, the value of the numbers will be increasing. As we move on to the left side of the zero, the values will be in the decreasing order, isn't it? Therefore, see here, they are given 0 and minus 8. See, where is minus 8? It is in the left side of the 0, means it is in the decreasing order, isn't it? Therefore, minus 8 is smaller than 0, isn't it? Therefore, 0 is greater than minus 8. Next, what they have given? 5 and minus 5. See here, where we have 5 plus 5. Plus 5 is on the right side of the 0, and whereas minus 5 is on the left side of the 0. We know that left side of the 0, the values will be in the increasing order. Therefore, minus 5 is smaller, isn't it? Therefore, plus 5 is greater than minus 5. Is that clear, children? See, in the next example, what they are given? 0 and 6. Both are positive numbers only, isn't it? Where we get 0 and 6. It is moving on in the right side, isn't it? Therefore, 6 is greater than 0, isn't it? Therefore, 0 is less than 6. Is it clear? Next example. What they are given? Minus 1, minus 15. Both are negative numbers only. See, here we have minus 1. What about minus 15? It will be moving on the left side of the 0. We know that the number moving on the left side of the zero will be decreasing, will be smaller number, isn't it? Therefore, minus 1 is greater number here, isn't it? Therefore, minus 1 is larger than minus 15. What about plus 11 and plus 15? Both are positive numbers. We know that where we get plus 15, we get 8, 9, 10, 11, isn't it? 11 here, later 12, 13, 14, 15. Means 15 is moving on the right side of the 0, isn't it? Therefore, which is the bigger number here? Both are positive, you can say it easily. Therefore, 15 is greater than 11, isn't it? This is an homework for you people. You have to solve by yourself. Now let us start the exercise. That is exercise 6.1. What they are given in the first question? Write the opposite of the following. So what they are given? First as increase in weight. You have to write down the opposite of this. What is increasing opposite? What is the opposite word for increase? That is decrease in weight. Next, what's there given in the next question? 30 kilometers north. What is opposite for north? See, this is north, south, west, east. Isn't it? Which is opposite for north here? South. Therefore, 30 kilometers north means what is the opposite for this? 30 kilometers south. Okay, next what they have given? 80 meters east. For east, which is opposite side? That is west. It is 80 meters west. Next, loss of rupees 700. Lost. Lost, opposite word for loss is gain. Gain of rupees 700. Next, 100 meters above the sea level. See, let us mark this 0. 0 as the sea level. Okay, 100 meters above the sea level means below the sea level means what is the opposite for above? Below the sea level. See the next question. What they have given in the next question? Represent the following numbers as integers with appropriate signs. In these sentences, they have given some of the numbers. We have to represent with an appropriate sign, that is positive integer, or we have to represent as negative integers by this sentence. What they have given? An aeroplane is flying at a height 2000 meters above the ground. See, let us draw a number line here. Let us mark the point zero as a ground. Let zero be the ground. What they have given us? An aeroplane is flying at a 2000 meters above the ground. 2000 meters above means right side of the zero, moving towards the upside, means it will be positive value only, isn't it? 200 meters above means it is an positive integer, that is plus 2000 meters. See, the next question is a submarine is moving at a depth. What do you mean by this submarine? Submarine means a ship moving under the water. What they are given? 800 meters below the sea level. Let 0 be the sea level. Let 0 be the sea level. 800 meters below the sea level. See, this is the above the sea level and this is below the sea level. Below means we will be having negative values only, isn't it? This will be minus 100, minus 200, minus 300. Similarly, we get minus 800. Therefore, below the sea level means the value will be minus 800 meters. See, the next question is a deposit of rupees 200. Deposit means we are going to put the amount in our account only, isn't it? For our emergency purpose, isn't it? Deposit means we are going to put the amount in our own accounts only. Therefore, it is a positive. Therefore, plus 200. Next, what are they given? Withdrawal of rupees 700. Now we are going to withdraw, means we had taking some amount from our account itself. Removing, isn't it? Therefore, it is a minus. Minus 700. See what they have asked in the next question. They have asked us to represent the following numbers on a number line. Here they have given some of the numbers. We have to represent these numbers on a number line. We know how to represent the numbers on a number line. In the last class we have discussed, isn't it? We have marked some of the numbers, isn't it? See. First draw a straight line. Draw a straight line. Mark exactly 1 centimeter each. Mark the points by taking exactly 1 centimeter each. Okay. In the middle of the zero, what we'll be having? We'll be having zero. And the right side of the zero, we'll be having positive values, isn't it? What they've given? They asked us to mark plus 5 on the number line, isn't it? Plus 5 means we have to move. 5 moves from the point 0. This is the first move from 0, that is 1. The next move we'll be having 2. Third move 3. Fourth move 4. And the last fifth move will be 5. We got plus 5 on the number line. What will be having on the left side of the 0? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 to infinity. Is that clear? So what are they given in the next question? They asked us to mark minus 10 on the number line. See here, in the middle of the line we have 0. Minus 10 means we have to move on the left side of the 0, isn't it? We have to move 10 moves. Why? Because I have given 10, minus 10. First move will be minus 1. Second move, minus 2. Third move, minus 3. Fourth move, minus 4. Fifth move, minus 5. Sixth move, minus 6. Seventh move, minus 7. Eighth move, minus 8. Ninth move, minus 9. And the last move, that is minus 10. Tenth move is minus 10. We have marked minus 10 on the number line. Is that clear, children? Now you came to know how to mark the integers on the number line, isn't it? Here there are some more examples here. Plus 8, minus 1 and minus 6. These are homework for you people. You have to mark by yourself. Okay, let us continue in the next class.